news was at dinner at the home of a Pharisee, and this woman comes in and says she had been a sinful woman. It's a whole other story. That's another sermon. But Jesus says to his host, he says, therefore I tell you, when he sees what she's doing, he says, I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, for she loved much. So the love is kind of evidence of her receiving forgiveness. Her love, her forward motion, the paralyzed one's ability to move, that's the evidence of forgiveness. Forgiveness is to move in a new direction. So our lives are no longer determined by the failures of our past. So there's a new possibility, an impossible possibility, that was born in this paralyzed person in the presence of Jesus. Jesus identified this new possibility as forgiveness. Forgiveness that we would never suspect. It's a surprising, awesome character of the love of God that is in our midst. So how may it be that you've been paralyzed in your life? What part of you might be paralyzed? There are many ways in which our ability to move can be lost. Whether through a physical paralysis, perhaps a mental paralysis, or an emotional paralysis, sometimes a spiritual paralysis. And the artist Picasso was kind of speaking about that, I think, when he observed that every child is an artist. The problem is how to remain an artist once we grow up. Sometimes we become crippled by our own defenses, the armor that we've constructed around ourselves to protect us from pain. That armor may become so thick and heavy that we lose our ability, we lose our power to move. Skepticism can paralyze us. In our day, it seems a paradox that even being busy can paralyze us. We lose track of what's truly important. A loss of wonder can paralyze us when our imaginations become shattered. Joylessness can rob us of our strength, of our colors. Fear of failure can paralyze us. For some, it's a fear of success and the changes that success might bring. So what keeps you from hearing the message, son or daughter, take heart? Your sins are forgiven. Rise. Walk. Take up that mat on which you've been confined and go home. It's a message that we long to hear, and one that seems strange somehow, impossible. Don't become lost in the paralysis of analysis, but begin to move with the guidance that God is giving to you, and trust that more guidance will come. That's to live by faith. I'm sure that man who was paralyzed never forgot that day. The day his friends, perhaps the people who were tired of taking care of him, let him down through that roof, and he was with Jesus and he was able to walk home. Mark says he didn't just limp out of there. That he did indeed. He picked up his mat and carried it out before all of them. It says that people were amazed and glorified God, saying, we've never seen anything like this. Luke's account of this same event says they were filled with fear, saying, we have seen strange things today. So who is this person, Jesus? Will he destroy all of our former convictions and our traditions? Everything that seems reasonable to us? Was he for real when he talked about each of us living life abundantly? Well, you can't find out if you're stuck on that. You have to stand up. You have to walk. It's your move. Please join me for one prayer. Gracious God, we thank you for the faith of those in our lives who have carried us to Jesus. We ask that when we find ourselves paralyzed, that we may be able to find the courage to move in Jesus' presence, that we may know the joy of forgiveness, that we may share your forgiveness with others, and that we may find the faith that is alive in us. ask it in Jesus' name.